Hello and welcome to Climbing Daily. On today's show we have an interview with climber Caro North about the route she and her team put up on Mount Inaki in the Kishtwar Valley in India.
I'm Caro North, I'm 26 years old, I live in Switzerland, originally I'm from Germany and I love climbing, mountaineering, ice climbing, alpine climbing. Last year we managed to go to the Kishtwar Valley and do some first descents and climb an unclimbed 5,000 meter peak, which was pretty awesome. So a couple of years ago, I went climbing to Yosemite with Stefan Siegrist. We were both on the Mammut team, and then he talked to me about this amazing walls in India and showed me the photos, and I was like, wow, I have to go there, and I have to go there before someone else goes to put up some new lines. For me, it was really hard to find partners because you need to have a lot of time, you need money to go so far away, your sponsors, and you need to be a strong climber and have a lot of experience in the mountains. If not, you cannot go on something unknown like this. So I was looking for partners like for 1.5 years, and then suddenly my two Chilean friends jumped on it and they're like, okay, let's go. And it was kind of 2 months before we wanted to go, which is pretty short to organize an expedition. But finally we managed to organize it and we were really lucky to go. So we arrived in Delhi, got together there, still had to wait for the luggage of the Chileans, which was lost somewhere around the world, I think in Canada or something. Then it finally arrived. And then we could start our drive. We drove 3 days up into the Himalayas and then started our walk with horses and our kitchen boy and our cook and everything and the liaison officer, and then walked for 4 days. So you walk through the villages and you get in contact with the people, and it's just amazing. And then you just arrive in the valley and you choose a flat place to do a base camp. I mean, there's no infrastructure, nothing. You're the ones to choose where to build up your base camp. So from our advanced base camp, we had a lot of peaks around and we were looking for new lines then, and we wanted to climb another exposure because the west facing, there was too much snow in it. So we saw this awesome southeast facing line and we were like, okay, let's go for that. We just have to try it. So we established our advanced base camp at 4,000 meters on the glacier, and from there we walked up to the wall. And our peak was about 5,300 meters high, and it was around 700 to 800 meters of granite wall to climb. To get to the rock part, we had to walk up some couloirs, climb up some icy couloirs, one a bit steeper where we really had to climb on our ice axes and belay, and then reached the rock face. And it was amazing. It was really warm in the summer, so we really climbed on rock shoes. We could take out our big boots and climb in the sun. It was amazing. So we climbed the route and we did it in an alpine push, so we didn't fix any ropes, but we had our little tent for us with us. But we didn't find anything on the wall at the beginning to sleep. It was so steep. It was amazing climbing, but there were no ledges and nothing. And we were like, oh no, where are we gonna sleep tonight? And then after 10 pitches, just suddenly we arrived to this perfect ledge, even with snow, which we could smell. And then we built up our little tent. I mean, we're carrying a 2-person tent for 3 of us and just 1 sleeping bag for the 3 of us. So we fit in all together, but if you wanna turn, you have to turn at the same time.
Hola, chiquillos. Despertándonos.
At the beginning we were climbing really steep granite, kind of on knobble, so it was hard to put any gear in it, but it was just this perfect quality knobble climbing. And then you had some cracks and even some big flakes. They were even reminding me of Yosemite. Awesome climbing. And I mean, you're climbing at an altitude between 4,000 and 5,000 meters, so you really feel it, and this steep climbing gets hard, but it's so amazing. And we climbed difficulties up to 60 plus 7A, which was really great. And then we just had this ice chimney in the middle of the route, which we had to pass, and this was quite tricky because it was in the shade and everything frozen inside, and it was quite loose. So we got scared because there was like big blocks falling down. But this was like for 3 pitches where the rock wasn't good and all the rest of the rock was really good. So the second day, after 2 pitches, we arrived at a slab part and then tried to climb up there, and there was no gear to put anything, and the slab was quite hard. And you're like, wow, how are we gonna pass this? Because you cannot just pass 15 meters of slab without any protection. It was too steep for us. And you're like, oh no, we were already scared that we had to turn around here, because sometimes you just come there and then you cannot climb up. And then finally we drilled a hand bolt, so we had one protection, but we put this really small bolt, so you don't really want to take a whipper on it. But yeah, it's better than nothing. I guess it's good for your head. And then climbed up and then over the bolt and climbed still 7 meters higher up, and then standing on the slab, drilled another bolt. And this was quite hard. We were all so scared. While belaying my friend, I was like, whoa, no, he shouldn't fall, because if he's gonna fall, he's gonna land on the ledge, and then this is gonna be a big problem. After that, there was a really nice, like, kind of overhanging crack system, which was good. And then at the end, we got more into the ridge, so the climbing got easier, like around 6A, something like that. And we continued up and up. And then at the upper part, we got some more snow into it. And then finally reached the summit, which was like incredible to stand on this amazing summit where no one has been before. If you climb an unclimbed peak, you can give it a name. So we named the peak Monte Iñaki after a good friend of ours, Iñaki Cusirat, an Argentinian climber who died in Patagonia the same year. So we really wanted to do something in honor of him, and we were like feeling that he's with us. And the route we named Namaste Dost, which means like hello, goodbye friend, Arista de los Sueños, which means like dream ridge. So at the moment, my big challenge is doing the mountain guide course. I really want to become a mountain guide and be able to give my passion for the mountains to show it to others. So this is taking hopefully until September, and then I've planned some expeditions for September, but I'm not gonna say where I'm going.
Thanks, Caro. For more information about her, make sure you check out the website in the copy below, and keep an eye out for the movie coming soon. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you later.